This short presentation will provide some definitions about bilingualism and multilingualism. I will first introduce what is bilingualism and what is multilingualism. Then I will introduce the differences between individual and societal bimultilingualism, as well as the difference between simultaneous and successive or sequential bimultilingualism, and within successive, the difference between early and late successive bimultilingualism. The presentation will finish with examples from bimultilingual children to illustrate the different types of childhood bimultilingualism. Bilingualism generally describes the ability to use two languages with varying degrees of proficiency. Often, the term bilingualism is used in the more narrow sense of childhood bilingualism, and it refers to children who grow up with two languages from birth or from a younger age due to family circumstances or a regional or migration context. Within the scope of bilingualism, there is a lot of individual variation. Usually, one of the languages is more dominant than the other one. The level of proficiency in the two languages and the maintenance depends on various factors, including how much and in which contexts each language is being used, sociocultural and political factors. For example, how much the languages are being used for communication or work purposes, what is the social status of the languages in the society or in the respective communities, and the speaker's emotional attachment to the languages. The term multilingualism describes the ability to use several languages. These are often for different functions in different contexts. Bilingualism and multilingualism are often used interchangeably to mean growing up using more than one language. Multilingualism can be studied from the perspective of the individual or the society. In the former, we study how individuals acquire the languages and what factors influence language developments. Societal multilingualism takes the perspective of the society and studies the socio-cultural reality of multilingualism. For example, multilingualism in a specific country, like Namibia or India. It addresses the context of use of different languages, for example, formal versus informal, use within the family, work, school context, and the language policies that are in place in each context. Within childhood multilingualism, an important distinction is between simultaneous versus successive or sequential multilingualism. We talk about simultaneous multilingualism when an individual acquires more than one language from birth. We talk about successive multilingualism when an individual acquires one language from birth, and this is the home or family language that is being used by the main caregivers to communicate with the child, and another one or more languages are acquired during early childhood. This additional language or languages are often the languages spoken outside of the family in the society. The final distinction is the distinction between early and late successive multilingualism. We talk about early successive multilingualism when one language is acquired from birth and the other language or languages is acquired between the age of 1 and 3 years. In the case of late successive multilingualism, again, one language is acquired from birth and the other one is acquired after the age of 3 in a naturalistic setting. Now we will look at some examples of children to illustrate these distinctions. Maria is 6 years old. She was born in Germany to an Italian and a German parent. At home, she speaks Italian with one parent and German with the other one. The school language is German, but she also has Italian classes 1 hour each week. Outside of home or school, she uses German in her music class, but she's also part of an Italian playgroup. Maria is a simultaneous bilingual child. Pedro is 5 years old. He was born in Andalusia to Spanish parents and grows up with Spanish in the home. The family moved to Catalonia when Pedro was 4 years old. In the kindergarten and outside of the home or school, he speaks Spanish and Catalan. Pedro is a successive bilingual child. Almica is 7 years old and was born in Guatemala. She was born to parents of Guatemalan and Mayan heritage. At home, she speaks Ixil, which is a Mayan language, and the language at school is Spanish. Outside the home and school, she's using Spanish as well. Almica is a successive bilingual child. The final child is Benjamin. Benjamin was born in Nigeria to a Ghanaian and a Nigerian parent. At home, he speaks Yu with one parent and English and Hausa with the other parents. Outside of home, he uses English, for example, in supermarkets, and Hausa in the neighborhood. Benjamin is a simultaneous bilingual child. To summarize, this presentation introduced the terms bilingualism and multilingualism and the difference between individual versus societal multilingualism. Within childhood multilingualism, the distinction was made between simultaneous versus successive and between early versus late successive multilingualism. Examples of children and their language histories illustrated the different types of childhood multilingualism. If you would like to read more about these definitions and types, here are some useful books and papers for further reading.